my name is Andrew Kim, and I am currently an undergraduate student here in Dr. Simmons' lab. And today I'll show you a quick look around the lab and introduce you guys to some of the undergraduate students, graduate students, and the senior staff. Let's head in. Here is our desk area. We can call this the clean zone because no gloves or lab coats are allowed in here. This is where most of the data analysis takes place, as you can tell by all the computers that's laying around here.
So this is one of the two main rooms in this lab. This room is dedicated to techniques dealing with mouse physiology. So this is where the microdissection, perfusion, DPOE, suctioning all take place. It stores many equipment such as the sound booth, dissecting scopes, vibratome, etc.
My name is Dwayne Simmons, and I'm chair of the Department of Biology and also the head of this particular laboratory. We do research on the auditory system and looking at aging and development within the auditory system. And we're very, very interested in mechanisms, molecular mechanisms and cellular mechanisms that are related to aging. In my laboratory, we have a lot of undergraduate students, as well as we have two graduate students and a postdoc and technical staff. I have a laboratory manager, and they all are working on various projects within the lab that relate to development as well as aging. And we are doing projects also about how to restore hearing loss once we've been impacted by either infection or by loud noises.
My name is Aubrey Hornack. I work at the Simmons Lab here at Baylor, and we are a hearing research lab. We are interested, especially right now, in age-related and noise-induced hearing loss. Today, I'm actually kind of relearning a technique that I was taught once. It's a microdissection. It can be really tedious, but I'm basically dissecting the cochlea, which is actually the organ of Corti, which is our hearing, contains our hearing organs, the hair cells of the inner ear, and trying to dissect them completely out of the cochlea.
Hi, I'm Andy Lee. I'm a junior biochemistry major. I joined Simmons Lab 2 summers ago, and I've learned how to do perfusions, microdissections, and a whole bunch of other things since. And the most rewarding thing about my experience in Simmons Labs so far is applying what I've learned in the classroom in a very real and practical sense. And I just love it here. It's great. Thank you, Dr. Simmons.
This side of the room, we see Dr. Clymer working on a project. Let's go meet her.
I'm Leslie Clymer. I am Dr. Simmons' postdoctoral fellow.
Right now, I'm working on a grant to get us some money because we can't work without money. Basically, in this lab, I kind of direct everyone's projects. So we have several students in the lab. We have 2 graduate students and something like a dozen undergraduate students. And we try and fit them in as effectively as possible into all of our projects. And it's really a big help when we have so many students here to help us do our projects. Really enjoyed working in this lab because Dr. Simmons brings out the positive best in everyone. I've never worked with such a large number of people, and everyone got on so well. And I think it really sets the tone for the environment of the lab. Is just, we're all here to help. We all want everyone to be happy, and we want everyone to do the best they can and be successful, and we will do everything we can to make sure that you feel that way too.
So Dr. Leslie Clymer is working with the students right now, and she is teaching Hannah here the different techniques to conduct a Western blot.
My name's Hannah. I am a first year PhD student rotating in the Simmons Lab. We are doing a Western blot today. We're trying to detect oncomodulin. So all first year cell biology PhD students at Baylor have to do lab rotations in 3 different labs. So this is my 2nd rotation, and I have been learning so much thanks to the wonderful Leslie, who has been so patient, especially with teaching me how to successfully do a Western blot, because I haven't done that yet. So we're hoping that works out today. But yeah, we've been having fun growing things in test tubes, so it's been good.
Now let's go meet Kate, who will show us around the cell culture room.
This is the cell culture room of the Dr. Simmons lab. Here we have our mammalian cell culture. We have both HEK 293 T cells and HeLa cells that we use for protein expression and transfection experiments. I'm pretty much the grad student who works in here a lot. We use mammalian cell culture in order to get a better idea of what molecular mechanisms are going on inside outer hair cells.
That was a quick look around our lab. I hope you have a better understanding of what Dr. Simmons' lab does, and I hope you can be our next member. Thank you for watching.